So the next item for us to work on, Milind, is this whole idea of safety stock and reordering materials, isn't it? That is the next thing.
That is correct.
Done some classification of items into A, B, C category. I don't recall fully what it was. Maybe worthwhile to refresh, relook at that.
Sure. Let's relook at it. In some sense, GV, this entire idea was very similar to the stockout discussion that
it
we had.
Here in this case, he had some curves and all. So
Correct.
Yeah. So what is the ABC analysis, right? So he mentioned that there are three categories. Yeah. Right? Okay.
Yes. So what I think what he had mentioned was that A category items were basically high value items.
Yeah.
Which means the cost of the item was high.
Mm.
And so he wanted to look at it just in time sort of purchasing.
So if you hold this in inventory, you're locking up a lot of capital. So you're trying not to do that. At the same time, you have to ensure that customers get the goods when they order it. So very planning, high amount of planning and just in time and all that, right? A lot of tracking. And I guess they spent a lot of management attention on this category. Huh?
Correct. And so you can see that there are two ways in which this management attention manifests.
Hmm.
One is accuracy of record keeping, or the, how live do you keep the data? That has to be extremely accurate.
Okay.
Because your purchase is completely in time.
Hmm.
On the other hand, the inventory or the warehouse manager is looking at very, very tight control on the stock.
Hmm.
So it's clearly a top priority item for him.
Mm, the FabMart case, we mobile phones, those costly mobile phones have been examples of this.
Correct.
In this case, in our case, we don't have any items because these are all gears and gear assemblies which are in the hundreds of rupees price point.
Correct.
So presumably they're not A items. Okay.
Yes.
Then there is C item, which is basically large quantity, low price, like soap and
things
like that, right?
Yes.
Groceries, basically.
Yes.
And this you would not control much. You would presumably also try and order it in bulk.
Correct.
Whole carton, 100 kilos or something, big amounts you will order so that you can get advantage of scale in purchase, isn't it?
Yes.
So, and you're not worried about whether you keep completely accurate account of.
Absolutely.
I see. Okay.
Yeah. So, the basic record keeping will be there, but the data doesn't need to be live minute to minute and so on.
It has to be correct, but it need not be instantaneously. You don't have to have it.
Correct.
So, we are not at CLs because we are not. At our price point, 600-700 rupees, whatever it is.
Yes.
We are not totally cheap. It's not like a 10 rupee or 20 rupee item.
No.
Okay, so we are B, presumably, huh?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. And, so what happens? And I think for B, what you have to do is, of course, the record keeping has to be good. Again, it doesn't need to be minute-to-minute live, but at least at the end of the day, you have to have a very clear picture of where you stand.
Okay.
And I think from a ordering perspective, there is a plan in place on when to order, how much to order, etc.
I see.
So there is some structure in that ordering. And of course, there is an effort, I think, to keep a certain basic minimum quantity of stock always in the warehouse.
Hmm.
And if you fall below that point, then you immediately order some preset quantity. I think that's the model that they're looking at.
All right. Okay. So we have to look at the safety stock. What is the safety stock level, right?
Okay.
So what is the method of doing that? I mean, there seems to be some method. So can you explain this curve again? I mean, I know when he explained it, I seem to understand, but maybe just explain it again.
I think the way to look at it, GV, is we should look at what is the number of blanks in stock on a daily basis. Okay. Obviously, as every shift works on some of the blanks, those blanks get issued to the factory from the warehouse.
That the issue rate is constant.
In this particular diagram, but actually maybe in the data it may not be, right? So only this diagram I think is a little simplified.
Okay. So straight lines basically because you have a constant issue rate.
That's correct.
Issue rate. So therefore it's time period by time period it just declines linearly.
Correct. So it just keeps going down, right? So the stock in the inventory keeps going down.
And then eventually goes to zero.
It eventually goes to zero.
But you should not order after it goes to zero. Then by then, otherwise you will have a stock out situation.
Yes. Okay. Yes. So you should figure out how much time it takes. Let's say it takes 3 days for us to get new stock.
Okay.
Then whatever amount of blanks we need for 3 days worth of production.
For the next 3 days. Oh, before
so
that.
If the lead takes 3 days, then whatever quantity of blanks we need for 3 days production. As soon as we hit that point, we should reorder.
That is called safety stock, right?
That is called reorder point. Which is basically demand during lead time plus safety stock. Now, what is safety stock? Safety stock is, right now we had assumed that the demand rate is uniform. Sending out things on a constant basis. But actually, it may go up and down.
Okay.
So, the most normal thing that you would do is you would approximate this demand rate by average demand or average user. Okay. However, in some shifts, you may actually produce more.
Okay.
And you should not be in a position where you are not able to do more. You know, this shift is being very productive, but you are not able to feed the shift because you don't have enough blanks.
Okay.
Right. So whatever is the maximum volume that a shift can produce, whatever is the maximum usage a shift may need, minus the average usage is the safety stock.
Oh, I see. Okay. So you have a reorder point, which is basically something. On top of that reorder point, you're adding another buffer, which is the safety stock.
Correct.
Which is basically the difference between the peak and the average, because you have done your calculation of reorder point based on average. But there could be a peak at that point. There could be a peak. So you are going to take the difference between peak and average. And that one you are going to add to this reorder thing. And that gives you the total quantity that you need to order. Isn't it?
No. So let me rephrase that. So let us say the lead time was 3 days. In 3 days, average consumption, let us say average consumption per day is 10 units.
Okay.
So then you would expect that for 3 days, you need 30 units.
Correct. You need 30 units. Correct.
So that is demand during lead time.
That is demand during lead time. Okay.
However, it is possible that on some days, instead of 10, you may actually need 12.
Okay.
So 12 minus 10 is safety stock, which is 2.
But that is for 1 day or it is, is that for 1 day?
It is for 1 day. So I'm sure we need to multiply the safety stock also by number of days probably.
Yeah.
We should ask that to shift.
Okay. All right. Okay. So we need some safety stock. So basically, okay, I understand. I get the principle. So we are looking at the lead time and multiplying that by the demand, average demand. And then there is some safety stock, some buffer on top of it for peak.
Yes. Okay. So the sense I get, Divi, and we should check this with Shiv, is that we are not doing maximum usage into number of into lead time. We are doing average usage into lead time plus safety stock.
That's safety stock. Okay.
If we do maximum usage into lead time, we will probably land up having too much stock in the warehouse.
Right. Correct.
Okay.
So this makes sense.
Yes.
It looks like they take the maximum only assuming that there is one day of
campus,
something like that.
Correct.
One day or I don't know, some number of days, but not equal to the entire lead time. So assume that entire lead time, then you're taking maximum multiplied by lead time. It's not that.
Correct.
Average multiplied by lead time plus the difference between maximum and average may be taken for 1 or 2 days or some number of days, which you call the safety. Okay. Get it. I get it.
And so the moment you hit the reorder point, you place an order.
You place an order, which is the reorder quantity.
Right? It continues to keep falling.
Uh-huh.
Because production continues, but you have not received the order.
You have not received the order. Yeah.
And then hopefully before the inventory goes to zero, you get...
It won't go to zero because you have done the safety stock. So it will go to safety stock.
Correct. But it will
go to safety stock. Sometimes it may go below safety stock if it is reaching or something. But yeah, but on average, it will basically just reach the safety stock level.
Correct.
And then, okay, understand.
Okay.
This is good. This is good, Mil. So can we do the working now?
Let's go look at the data. What data has Shiv given us?